What's up, Wildcats? I'm here with
Christina Dalce.
And today we're going to ask her a few quick questions about her pregame routine. So, Christina, what is something that you do every game outside of practice, outside of conditioning, that gets you locked in and ready to play physically and mentally?
Definitely music. I go back to my room after pregame meal, and I listen to music with Z, and we just start jamming out and relax, you know, lay in bed, and make some TikToks, you know, right before we get ready to leave. But definitely that for sure.
That's incredible. What kind of music?
Oh, that was stupid. It's so random. It's like, sometimes I listen to R&B, sometimes I listen to hip hop, sometimes I listen to Spanish music. What else do I listen to? Like slow jams, alternatives. It's just whatever I'm in the mood for, you know. But I was down for it. It's always like the main one's definitely rap, like some hype music type beat, like.
upbeat.
It's like upbeat though. It's like,
do you have any of like your favorite like artists recently or like albums, something that stands out to you?
No, not really. It's more like the songs, but it's just like whatever I come across, and it's like whatever I'm like, oh, this is different than I'm like, okay. And so yeah.
Amazing. Okay, so next question I have for you is more about your season so far. So as the women's basketball team is climbing those AP poll rankings, what is something that has contributed to the team's success behind the scenes that has really paid off?
Definitely team connection for sure. Just us bonding more and having to do a lot of team activities together. And I think that the team this year is definitely meshing well. So bringing that on the court is definitely making a big impact. And even on the court, like, we just determined that we can make it far. So now that we are higher than we were last year, then it's definitely like, okay, we need to finish off this season on a high note.
What's the energy you're feeling towards going into that Big East tournament, March Madness season? How are you guys feeling?
Very, very hyped, very excited. A tad bit nervous, just a tad. But definitely the seedings, like March Madness so far, when we finish off the season strong, then we're definitely hosting the first two games of March Madness. So it's going to be great. And Nova hasn't done that yet. So it's nice to make history. You know what I'm saying?
Make history it is. I love to see it. What do you admire most about your Villanova women's basketball team culture?
Just how, like, with all the pressure going around, around us this season, just us staying cool, calm, and collected and still having fun on and off the court, and just like not like putting any pressure on each other, but just to stay bonded and stay connected.
Now we're going to dip into a little bit of fun questions here with Chris. Okay, so Chris, what is your biggest hot take right now?
You is the best Netflix show on right now, and the best Netflix show on Netflix, point blank, period.
What about you makes it the best right now, and period?
definitely, like, the storyline just from off of season 1 and 2, and then I was watching season 3, and then I looked, and they dropped another season. I'm loving season 3, so season 4 right after that, chef's kiss.
Moving on, we have, what is your favorite pregame snack or meal?
If it's a late game, I prefer having pasta. Pasta with pesto is always the way to go. If they don't have pesto, I'll take bolognese, they call it, like the meat sauce. I'll have that. If it's in the morning, then I do like a little eggs or an omelet with bacon. But definitely, I'll eat whatever is in front of me. Not to sound bad, but yeah, I just, whatever tastes good. I need to fill up anyway, so I don't care.
That sounds absolutely delicious. Next question for you is, if you had a go-to celebration, and I know you're a big dancer from your intros at Hoops Mania for the past 2 years, yeah, share what your celebration would be.
Mm. I would do, I've had a lot. I did the gritty. Yeah, I did the gritty, or like maybe some leg work, like a little shake in the leg, a little something, or some like feet work, you know, toe action. I don't know. But yeah, I think those are my go-tos, those three. And then, you know, whatever comes up in my mind after that, like I'll do like a shimmy shimmy disco. I got a lot of stuff in my arsenal, you know. So
got a lot of stuff.
A lot.
Can't wait to see it. Can't wait to see it. All right. Lastly, final question. Do you have something that is special to you, or like a piece of memorabilia that you bring with you to games, or something that is like a good luck charm?
I bring myself. I think I'm my own good luck charm. I don't have any like items or clothing or bracelets. I know I used to wear a lot of bracelets in the beginning, but now it's just like me coming with an open mind, and of course my music. I always gotta have my AirPods. AirPods, Beats headphones. I guess that's what it is. Always have to have headphones. If I don't have headphones with me, I don't know how I'm gonna feel. It might throw me off a little, because then I'm gonna start thinking about where my headphones are at. So I'm gonna say that. Yeah.
Love the AirPods. They're amazing. Man. I can't live without mine either. Absolutely. And what is one thing you wanna leave the cats and other fans who are excited to watch you and the improvement of just the season?
Definitely stay tuned. Definitely show the support. And if you see us on campus, don't be afraid to say hi. We are very welcoming people. And I hope to see you at the games. We got a couple more home games left, too, of the season. So hopefully y'all can pop out. So go Cats.
Go Cats it is. Thank you.